Well, dear students, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, and today I am going to deal with meanings into words. The first unit of meanings into words, that is the grammar portion, that language teaches us the grammar patterns and language skills. Now, in unit 1, that is meanings into words unit 1, we have in 1.1, unit 1.1, we have experiences and achievements. Let me tell you slightly about the differences between experiences and achievements. Students, to understand this language item, we need to have the clear vision, clear concept about the experiences and achievements. You know, slightly there is a little difference between experiences and achievement. You know, experience, exactly in Nepali we say it is anubhav, anubhavharu, and achievements, you know, upalabdhi. So what is the difference between experience and achievement? Students, experience is simply our knowledge of doing something. Once you do something, that becomes your experience. For example, I have visited Pokhara. It is my experience. I have experience of visiting Pokhara. I have completed my homework. Now, I have completed my homework. That is my achievement. Means something that we have done in our life. That is our experience. And something we have completed. Something, there is sense of completion, you know. Once we have completed something, there may not be the need of completing it again. There may not be the need of doing it again. So achievement, you understand, there is the sense of completion. Means once we have achieved something, once we have gained something, there may not be the need of repeating it. There may not be the need of doing it again. I said, for example, I cooked rice, that is my achievement. I don't need to cook it again. I passed MA in 2008. I've written here, you see, I passed MA in 2008. Means, do I have to pass MA again? No, there may not be the need. Yes, if I want to do in other subjects, there may not. So usually, let me tell you, usually we don't have to repeat something when we have achieved it. Usually only, not always. For example, I am a teacher by profession. I have received regularity award. Now, I have received regularity award. That is my achievement. Now, what do you say? Can't I achieve the regularity award further in the future, in the days to come? Of course I can. Someone is an actor. The actor has received Filmfare award, Oscar award. Now, that is the achievement of the actor. Can the actor receive another Filmfare award, another Oscar award in the days to come or not? Of course, can. That means it is not always. Achievement does not always mean that there is no need, there is no chance of doing it again. It means sense of completion. Once you have completed something, that is your achievement. And once you have done something in your life, that is your experience. Now, when we talk about our experience and achievement, we can use two tenses here. I have mentioned clearly present perfect. That is the structure, you know, the pattern of present perfect. Subject has have verb 3. Verb 3, for our convenience, we call it verb 3. It is the past participle form. Past participle form of the verb. Has have, you focus on has have plus verb 3, that is present perfect. And then simple past, subject plus verb 2, that is the past form of verb. So present perfect and simple past, these two tenses can be used to talk about our experience and achievement. But there is a difference, you know, different situations. What is that? When we use present perfect tense, we can't mention the time. I can't say, for example, I have passed MA in 2008, because I mentioned time here. If I mention time, I must say I passed MA in 2008. That means when we mention time, we use simple past, and when we don't mention time, we use present perfect. I repeat in Nepali, हामी आफ्ना उपलब्धि र अनुभवहरूको बारेमा कुरा गर्दा हामी दुईटा टेन्स प्रेजेन्ट पर्फेक्ट र सिम्पल पास्टको प्रयोग गर्छौँ. सिम्पल पास्टको प्रयोग गर्दा हामी समय दिन सक्छौँ. हामीले समय देखाउँदाखेरि कहिले गरेँ, कुनै काम कहिले गरेँ, मैले कुनै उपलब्धि मैले उपलब्धि प्राप्त गरेँ, मैले कुनै काम पूर्ण गरेँ, पुरा गरेँ, कहिले गरेँ, 2050, last month, last year. When we mention time, it can be either year, month, season, whatever. Time, if you mention time, hami samay dekhaunchhau bhane, samay tokera hami yadi express garchhau bhane, apna anubhav ra hamra achievements haru, upalabdhi ra अनुभवहरूलाई एक्सप्रेस गर्दाखेरि समय तोकेर दिन्छौँ भने हामीले सिम्पल पास्टको प्रयोग गर्ने, र समय दिँदैनौँ भने, इफ वी डोन्ट मेन्सन द टाइम अफ एक्सन, देन वी युज प्रेजेन्ट पर्फेक्ट. द्याट्स क्लियर? ओके, सो नाउ वी आर इन युनिट 1.2. इन 1.2 यु सी सम सेन्टेन्सेस आर गिभन. These sentences give us information about different individuals, different professionals, personalities, and we have to make a list of some experiences and achievements of these individuals. And then after that, we need to develop those experiences and achievements into a paragraph. Means we are going to develop this sentence, we are going to make a paragraph. That paragraph may have 5 to 6 sentences, at least 6 to 7 sentences you can write, and all those sentences, all those sentences must be either simple past or present perfect, because we are going to talk about the experiences and achievements of these individuals. Let's see, for example, she has had an amazingly successful film career. She has had an amazingly successful film career. That means she has had positive experiences. Now you can say, she has had an amazingly successful film career. She has acted in 50 films so far. Most of her films have been blockbusters. She won a Filmfare Award in 2008. Her performance in film has been widely appreciated by the critics. She also gave her voice as a playback singer in her last movie, entitled, you can give the title of the movie, anything. Now, when we talk about the experiences of these people, the achievements of these people, we use simple past or present perfect. That is the focus here. Similarly, see, the company has had one of the worst years in its history. The company has had one of the worst years in its history. That means very bad experience, the negative experience of the company, you have to focus here. Yeah, The company has had one of the worst years in its history. The workers went on a strike at the very beginning of the year for 15 days, demanding the increase in the salary. Now, the workers went on a strike for 15 days at the beginning of the year, demanding increase in the salary. Next, we can say, the products of the company have not been able to compete with other products in the market. The finished products of the company have remained useless in the store for 6 months due to the lockdown and corona pandemic, you can say. And similarly, you can say, fire broke out in the month of September and the raw materials of 20 lakhs turned to ashes, and the insurance company refused the claim for compensation. So this is how the bad experiences of the company, the worst experiences of the company, you can develop them into paragraph. Similarly, the escaped prisoner has an impressive criminal record. Now, here we have some students have confusion about impressive criminal record. How can a criminal has impressive record? Because impressive is positive in a sense. Here we can say the criminal has involvement in very big crimes, you can say, not ordinary, simple, very big crimes. For example, involvement in the royal massacre, yes. Involved the criminal was involved in the massacre, or you can say assassination of the some politicians, the leaders, political leaders, you can say VIP personalities involved in the serial bomb blast, you can say involved in the murder of many very famous personalities, VIPs. That is one sense, and another sense. And another sense, you can say, impressive. The criminal robbed the rich businessman, rich people who have collected the black money. Those people who have large amount of black money, the criminal robbed those people and he distributed among the poor. He distributed among the poor means he committed crime, robbing the poor people, rich people. He committed crime, robbing the rich people, but he never used that money for his personal benefit, for personal life. He utilized that money for the welfare of the poor people. He fed poor people. He gave clothes to the poor people. He managed houses or say residence for the poor people with all his money, all his robbed money, you can say. Means criminal as a profession, criminal but contributed. In that sense, we can say the criminal has impressive criminal record. That is one sense. So you can write about the criminals experiences and achievements in the same way. This is how we conclude unit 1.2.